Hi to everybody. So today let's discuss about cell cycle and division. So now, before entering into the topic, let's know about some basic things. Okay. So the very important characteristics of this living organism is continuity of life. Right. So how this continuity of life can be achieved? With a process called reproduction. So reproduction is a very important thing for the living organisms. How this reproduction is involved? With the help of two basic processes. The first thing is cell growth and then cell division. So here, what is going to happen in the cell growth? Mainly, it is a period of synthesis. Okay, what is going to be synthesis here? So there will be the synthesis of various proteins and also chemicals used for the development and function of a cell. Okay, so this is the one thing. The next thing is duplication of genome and also various components of the cell. What do I mean by genome? Genome is nothing but a complete genetic material in an organism. So, if this has happened, a cell will undergo growth. Okay? When the cell undergoes growth, then the cell division is going to happen. So, what is going to happen in the cell division? For example, an adult cell is taken. Okay? So, this cell will undergo division to form two daughter nuclei or two daughter cells. Okay, so when these two daughter cells will undergo division, in the sense it will form four daughter cells. Right, so now let's enter into the topic cell cycle. So what is meant by cell cycle? I have clearly told you about the cell growth and division. So there are various changes is going to happen inside the cell growth and division. Right, so these changes are collectively called as cell cycle. Got it? So the changes occurs during cell growth and division is collectively called as a cell cycle. Okay, so there are two parts of cell cycle. So what are those parts? So the one is interphase, and then the second one is M phase or mitotic phase. So this interphase consists of three subphases, which is nothing but G1, S, and G2. Okay, so here this M phase consists of karyokinesis and cytokinesis. So let's see one by one. So the first of all, we are getting into this interphase. So these interfaces having various names. Okay, if we understand those various names, we can find out the function of this interphase. So what is the first name for this interphase? That is intermitosis. So mitosis, which is nothing but M phase. Okay, so what is meant by inter? It is between. Okay, so this interphase is going to happen between the two M phases. Okay, so now let's write. It is a period between one cell division. So what is going to happen in the mitosis? Cell division is going to happen. Okay, so it is a period between one cell division to the beginning of next cell division. Clear? So now coming to the second name for this interphase. Next one is resting phase. So it is going to take rest. Yes, obviously. So there won't be any visible changes in this phase, which is related to the cell division. Okay. In related to the cell division, there won't be any changes. Okay. Related to cell division. Okay, fine. So what are the other names? So the other names are preparatory phase, metabolically active phase, and then energy phase. So as this name suggests, here there will be the number of biosynthetic activities is going to happen. Okay, so what do you mean by biosynthetic activities? What is meant by biosynthetic activities? So there will be the synthesis of macromolecules and also other cell constituents, which is required for the cell division. Okay, so now we are going to see about other subphases of this interphase. So this is the cell cycle. Okay, so in this cell cycle, this interphase starts from here to here. So this is called as a interphase or I phase. Okay. So I'm doing this. Yes. Okay. So this is the interphase. And here it is a M phase. So here I already told you in M phase there are two subphases, that is karyokinesis and cytokinesis. This karyokinesis has four phases again. The first thing is prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. Okay, so these are the karyokinesis and then cytokinesis is going to happen here. So this phase is called as a G0 phase. We are going to see this G0 phase finally. Okay, now let's come to the interphase. Let me change the color. So now here, this is the G1 phase. Okay, so now what is going to happen here? Now let's see the various names of this G1 phase. So this G1 phase is also called as a gap 1, or it is called as a post mitotic phase. So why it is called as a post mitotic phase? It is happening after this M phase. So M phase is called as a mitotic phase. So that's why we are calling this as a post mitotic phase or presynthetic phase. So it is happening before the S phase, right? So this is the S phase. So this is the G2 phase. Okay. Then finally, it is also called as a first growth phase. Okay. So what are the things is going to happen here? So the first thing is there will be the pooling of amino acids. Okay. So why the pooling of amino acids is formed here? Because for the synthesis of the proteins. Obviously, right? The proteins are made up of amino acids. And then the second thing, there will be the pooling of nucleotides. Okay, so why nucleotides are formed here? For the synthesis of RNA molecules. Okay, and also there will be the synthesis of energy molecules. It needs energy, right? For the synthesis of the DNA. So here the DNA is going to get duplicated in the next stage. So that's why the energy molecules are produced here. And also there will be the synthesis of macromolecules. What do you mean by macromolecules? So there will be the production of carbohydrates, lipids, all those stuffs. So basically in this G1 phase, the cells are metabolically very active. So let me draw the cell in this G1 phase. So let's consider this is a cell. Okay. So, okay. This is the cell just present in the G1 phase. Now let's enter into the S phase. Let me change the color for this S phase. I'll go with green. Okay, fine. So what is going to happen in this S phase? So this S phase is also called as a synthetic phase. Okay, so here the main thing is going to happen. The first thing is DNA start replicates. Okay, so after this replication, there will be the formation of two sister chromatids, and there will be the formation of centromere also. Okay, and also the main thing is there will be the synthesis of histones. So histone is a basic protein, right? It gives shapes to the chromosomes, and also it will be controlling the activity of the genes. Okay, it's a very important basic protein. So let me draw the cell in the S phase. So as I've already told you, the DNA gets duplicated. Fine. So I have told you two sister chromatids, right? Here is one chromatid and this one is a chromatid. So these are the sister chromatids. Fine. Clear. Now let's enter into the G2 phase. I'll go with the blue. Okay. So here there are various names for this G2 phase also. So it's quite opposite to the G1. That is, G2 is also called as a gap 2. And it is also called as a pre-mitotic phase. Right. So it is happening before this M phase. So that's why we are calling it as a pre-mitotic phase. And then we can call it as a post-synthetic phase, because it is happening after the S phase. And it is also called as a second growth phase. So what are the things is going to happen in this G2 phase? The first thing is there will be the synthesis of spindle fiber. So it's just a filament used for the division of the cell. The second thing is there will be the synthesis of three types of RNA. So what are the three types of RNA? Which is nothing but tRNA, mRNA and rRNA. Okay, the third thing is there will be the synthesis and storage of ATP molecules. Okay, again it's an energy molecule which is used for the cell division. Okay, so now we are going to enter into this M phase. So what is going to happen in the M phase? I have already told you in M phase, let me change the color. Yeah. So karyokinesis and then cytokinesis is going to happen. So this karyokinesis consists of four phases. What do you mean by karyokinesis? It's a nuclear division. Okay. So the cytokinesis is cytoplasm division. Okay. So now In the karyokinesis, there are four phases, right? The first one is prophase. Let me change the color for this prophase. I'll go with red. Okay, so let me draw the prophase, how the cell will be looking like. Okay, so consider this is the cell. Okay, then chromosomes are here. Actually, I forgot to tell you how the cell will be looking like in this G2 phase. So at this G2 phase, the chromatids will start condensing for the cell division. Okay, so here is the chromosome. Here, that is genetic material, which is surrounded by the nuclear membrane. Fine. So here, the nuclear membrane start disappearing. It's a very important thing. So here, the nuclear membrane starts disappear. So what is the next change is going to happen? So there will be the centriole, right? In a cell. So here, there are two centrioles, which starts to form a astral rays. Astral rays are formed by centriole. Okay, so what is the function of this centriole? The centriole will be helping this cell division by moving this chromosome to the poles with the help of the spindle fibers also. And also there will be the spindle fiber. There will be the formation of spindle fiber inside the cell. So these are the changes going to happen in the prophase. Now let's enter into the metaphase. So the second thing is metaphase. Now here, look at the chromosome. Here the centriole is present. So here the chromosomes are arranged at equator. So it is the center, right? It is in the center. So here the chromosomes are arranged at equator, or we can also call it as a metaphase plate. All the chromosomes will be in the equator region, which is at the center. Okay, now let's see the anaphase. So what is going to happen in the anaphase? So let me draw the cell first of all. Here the centrioles. Okay, now here the two sister chromatids are separated. Fine. So in the anaphase, daughter chromosomes are separated. Okay, with the help of the centrioles, the centrioles will be pushing this two sister chromatids to the opposite poles. Okay, finally the two sister chromatids are separated. Now let's get into the telophase. This is the fourth one. So inside the telophase, the nuclear membrane starts appearing, and then there will be the formation of cleavage furrow. What do you mean by cleavage furrow? It starts to begins the progression of cleavage. The two cells have to get separated, right? So that is called as a cleavage furrow. So in plants, okay, the cell form, cell division will be separated by the cell plate formation. But here, the furrow will be formed. So after this, the cytokinesis is going to happen. So which means two cells are get separated, okay? So this is all about this yum phase. So this is the cytokinesis. So there are some examples for the duration of cell cycle in various organisms. So the cell cycle duration for this bacterial cells will be about, it's just for the example, and it will takes about 20 minutes. And for the yeast cell, it will take some 90 minutes. And for the human intestinal epithelial cells, it will take about 8 to 10 hours. Okay. For the onion tip, okay, root tip is there, right? So for that, it will take about 20 hours. And for the human cell in culture, okay, it will take about 24 hours. Okay. So these are the approximate durations for this different types of cells. Now, let's see about the regulation of cell cycle. So I have told you about the G0 phase, right? So for example, let me draw this cell cycle, okay? So just consider this is the prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase, okay? And then cytokinesis, and have draw this G0 phase, right? So in this G0 phase, the cell will stop its division and it will get mature and differentiate, okay? When the cell get differentiated, it does not come to the cell cycle next time. This is one case. Okay. When the differentiated cell Okay, coming into the cell cycle for the division, it is entering into the G1 phase. Okay, so that is called as dedifferentiation. Okay, so be clear with the term differentiation. When a cell stops its division and it gets matured and differentiated. Okay, when this differentiated cell wants to undergo cell cycle again, it may come and enters to the G1 phase. So that is called as a dedifferentiation. So after the cell is dedifferentiated, again it wants to come out of the cell cycle, it is called as a redifferentiation. Okay, so these are the basic terms, you have to be very clear with it. So this G0 phase is also called as a quiescent phase. So it is also called as a phase of arrested. Okay, thank you.